Let's take it across to Ruchi Bhatia, my colleague, who's been picking up on this mega privatization and disinvestment drive, which also involves PSU banks. Ruchi, what exactly are you picking up?
Well, Aisha, it was on the 15th of July that we at ET Now told our viewers that the Modi government's mega privatization drive is going to include banks as well. We are given to understand that the interministerial consultations for identifying strategic and non-strategic sectors has already been floated. The draft cabinet note for it has already been floated, and banks and insurance companies are very much a part of strategic sectors. So as a policy, in terms of what the finance minister had announced, that strategic sectors will entail retaining 1 to 4 public sector entities and privatizing the rest of them. It goes on to show that the government is keen to retain the top 4 to 5 banks in the long term. However, privatization is going to be the buzzword for the remaining banks. We're given to understand that the government is eyeing privatization of the unmerged banks first. Among them includes the likes of Bank of India, Central Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, IOB, Bank of Maharashtra and UCO Bank. This is a story that we first told our viewers back in, back last week on the 15th. On the back of that, others also seem to be reporting the same story now. And also goes on to show that, privatization is very much going to be what the Modi government is going to do. They are looking at widening the process of strategic sectors as well, which will entail privatization of many more PSUs in different areas, whether it's oil and gas, fertilizers, power. So it's not just restricted to banks. There is much more that is in the offing.